the capital of the only democracy in the Middle East. When I was a teenager, I lived some years in this beautiful country and in the city Jerusalem, and I visited Israel more times than I can count. Israel, the only country in the region with a functioning parliament, with a rule of law, and with free election. The only country in the whole region that shares our values of our Western societies. In fact, is one of the foundations of our Judeo-Christian identity. And we are here today to voice our concern over the growing Islamization of the West. We do it in this city, the city of David, the city that, together with Rome and Athens, symbolizes our ancient heritage. And perhaps a few of you may be new to Jerusalem, yet Jerusalem is not new to any of you. We all carry Jerusalem in our blood, in our genes. We all live and breathe Jerusalem. We talk Jerusalem. We dream Jerusalem, simply because the values of ancient Israel have become the values of the rest. We are Israel, and Israel is in all of us. This city, ladies and gentlemen, this city is the capital of a democracy under threat. Israel is under siege, like the Jewish community in the land of Israel is under siege for over a century now. Israel, with all its glory and splendor, is unique and its history unparalleled. Yet, Israel's security situation is not unique, and neither is its enemy. Samuel Huntington wrote it so truly: Islam has bloody borders. Israel is located precisely at that border. This tiny country is situated on the fault line of jihad, just like Kashmir, like Kosovo, the Philippines, southern Thailand, Darfur in Sudan, Lebanon and Aceh in Indonesia. Israel is simply in the way of the Islamic advance, just like West Berlin was during the Cold War. And Israel is simply receiving the blows that are meant for all of us. If there would have been no Israel, Islamic imperialism would have found other places to release its energy and its desire for conquest. Therefore, the war against Israel is not a war against Israel. It's a war against the West. It's the war against us all. It's jihad. And thanks to Israeli parents who see their children go off to join the army and lie awake at night, parents in Europe and parents in America can sleep well and have pleasant dreams, unaware of the dangers. At present, the front line of the jihad runs not through the streets of Tel Aviv and Haifa only, but also through the streets of London, Madrid, and even Amsterdam. Jihad is our common enemy, and we better start facing jihad before it's too late. Therefore, if we voice our concern over the Islamization of the West, we have to do it here in Jerusalem, where our civilization borders on Islam, where jihadists fire Qassams into civilian homes in Sderot and Ashkelon, and where a doctor like Ari Eldad is characteristic of our civilization by treating terrorists the same way as he treats Israeli victims. I salute Professor Eldad for his work for humanity and for his patriotism. And I thank him. Professor Eldad, for hosting this conference in this great city. Ari, I'm proud to be your friend. I will say a few things about the Islamization of Europe and my film Fitna that you just saw. I will use some examples from my own country, the Netherlands, because they are indicative for the situation on the continent. First, the mass immigration. The mass immigration to the Netherlands continues full speed ahead. Currently, a staggering number of new immigrants arrive every year. Many of them Muslim, often uneducated, if not illiterate, bringing along with them the local customs of the mountains and deserts of backward Islamic countries. Thousands and thousands of Muslims arrive in the Netherlands every year, while already 1 million Muslims are living in our tiny country. And there are many, many problems concerning this massive influx. Immigrants are overly represented in social benefits and crime statistics, and the overall costs are staggering. The financial cost of this mass immigration in the Netherlands exceeds 100 billion euros. But what we have to fear most is the creeping Islamization, the stealth jihad. Because every Islamic neighborhood, every Islamic shop, every mosque, every Islamic school, every burqa, every veil is regarded by many Muslims as building blocks towards a larger goal, and that goal is domination. And this, in fact, is the essence of our problem. Not the crime, not the financial burden. The biggest problem is the demographic development and the way it influences our societies at large. Immigration from Muslim countries and the demographics will result in the Arabia that the brave Bakir Hor warned us all about. It will become reality if we don't act now. A decade and a half ago, the unknown American politician used a slogan in his political campaign. He said, "It's the economy, stupid." And from now on, the motto of my party will be, "It's demographics, dumbo." More than 40 years ago, the British politician gave a famous speech. He stated that, looking into the future, he saw rivers of blood as a result of the uncontrolled influx of immigrants. His name was Enoch Powell. And Enoch Powell's speech was the starting point of a debate of mass immigration in Europe. As usual, the leftist establishment labeled him an extremist and his career went down. But the British people loved him and supported him. London's dock workers took him into their hearts, marching by thousands in the support of Mr. Powell. And looking back, I share Enoch Powell's alarmist views on mass immigration. But rivers of blood is not something I see happening. We will not face civil war in Europe. Our political elite is trying to make us believe that the influx of Muslim immigrants is similar to the waves of immigrations that took place centuries ago. Or they will say and fool us by saying that Christianity developed towards modernity and therefore Islam will do the same. But how, ladies and gentlemen, how are we to remain a democracy if a large part of the growing Muslim population is in favor of introducing Sharia law? How is Amsterdam to remain the gay capital of Europe if gays are regularly beaten up by Western immigrants, often Muslims? How are the Jewish communities of Europe and Amsterdam, how can they survive with the growing presence of an ideology that is so blatantly anti-Semitic? How are we to remain the center of cultural and scientific excellence if Islam opposes art and academic exploration? How are we to remain an open and tolerant society if we are faced with part of the Muslim community favoring self-determination